Hello everybody, Icesori here. I have a nice gameplay for you, which I played today with my SU-130 Tier 8 Premium Russian Tank Destroyer, and it's on a infamous map, Prokhorovka, Kampinovka, whatever you want to call it. It's great. So we're going to have a blast game, I hope, and you will enjoy it too. What are we basically saying here? Basically, this is a, how would we call it? The enemies, you know, we're talking about tier 9 game, tier 8. Tier 9, tier 8 game, which is okay for this tank. Penetration's nice. Guns behaving most of the times, I have to say. And all you have to do is basically just, they say, sit back and wait. Sometimes, when your team suck, you have to take things into your own hands. And even though you are playing lightly armored, it's a Russian whale. Armored tank destroyer at tier 8 with it in a tier 9 game, you have to simply try and do what you can do, you know, to help your team win. And that's what we will do in this game. So, first shot, really bad aim. I was hoping for good RNG, but it never happened. That's fine. So we're going to take our V position, which we usually take up in a V bush, up on the top of this V hill, very, very shortly. We will hope to get some good snipes down to enemy heavies in the middle, or maybe even the light tanks, like that one right there, that LTTB, hello sir. Hit. Yes, thank you very much. 528. So the standard penetration on this tank, it's okay. Okay, I have to be said, this is a really, really good tank for sniping, for making sure that, you know, you can penetrate your targets. The I very, very rarely use heat on this gun, very rarely. I mean, maybe once in 10, 15 battles. There you go. I was a high roll, 565, lovely. Can't really complain there. So we're already up to 1,093 damage. And we are hoping that enemy is going to make more mistakes that we could punish. We have... Well, currently we are losing 1-2, okay, which is alright. It's only standard game. So sitting in the bush, looking at our heavy is coming forwards. We are slightly pushing this flank, which is good. Which means that our team wants to win this flank, which is great. They don't want to just sit about and expect something miraculous happen. Since I am a TD, I'm sitting at the back, waiting for our tanks to spot. There's medium UDES sitting there. Type 4 heavy is pushing forwards as well. And I'm just slightly moving forward to the closer bush, so if there's anybody at the back, I can see them and shoot at them. Possibly, maybe spot even a few tanks. So what we are seeing right there is, there is Panther 2 at H1, which is being eliminated from the game, which will hopefully bring more confidence into our team's front. People there are moving forward. There you go. Ulysses is already pushing forward. And we are expecting some tanks over there. Oh, there is LTTB. He's eliminated. Very good. Was a good player. Obviously didn't play that well this game. And there's the 555A. 488, that's low roll again, you know. So you get high roll, you get low roll, basically. All in all, you end up near enough the same as an average damage, which is fine. Can't really be complaining about that, which the average damage on this tank is supposed to be 530, which is quite nice. And with the, your penetration is quite high, so you don't really have to be worried too much shooting at even heavier armor. What we are expecting now is our WZ-120 have moved quite aggressively forward, but UDES is now pushing too, and we are hopefully will get some good spots from these guys. Very good. So this is T55A, sir. With critical damage, that's fine. Critical damage will do. Charioteer, well, I'm still reloading. Reloading. We've got lovely. Well, we didn't have to shoot at that point, but there you go. So they have, we are winning 6-4 right now, which is quite good information for us right there, so we can move forward. And I'm thinking about moving to the top bush over here, which is usually used at the start of the battle, because from that position you can do shoot at the enemies in the middle quite easier. So there's Löwe being spotted right there, so I'm relocating my pointer to him to see if I can hit him, and I'm waiting for some good pen. There you go, 516. Not a just slightly below the standard roll. Oh dear, dear. There's that WZ1114 in the middle. I'm trying. I'm hoping for a good shot, but unfortunately RNG says nope, and we are moving just forward again. So that's fine. We can't really complain. It happens. Waiting for a few middle guys, their T10 IS-3 to maybe even spot those WZ MX-50-120. It's 7-6, which is still a tight game, and we are trying, hopefully, from this position to protect the middle, which is quite important in this encounter game. Okay, so there's, yes, 472, again, low roll. That's fine, critical damage as well, so we'll take that. This guy is just moved in behind a V-Ridge, so he can't really have access to any more shooting over to his armor. IS-3 seems to be moving forward, but it doesn't. I think he's just falling back there, really. So you have to keep an eye on your maxi map and ensuring that you really understand where is everybody's position. Currently our T-44-100 and Conway are doing probably what I am doing, but from far worse position, because from there to hit like the turret of the WZ-11114, not really good, is it? So I'm still patient, and 8-6, which is not too bad. We seem to be fighting for the hill. WZ-1114 have moved, so that means I can move also. There's only that 50-120, which is only tier 9 French heavy tank autoloader with quite a good burst damage, but what can we do? So I'm moving forward. I'm just saying, right, okay. So what am I expecting to see is hopefully we get some shot. Well, bad shot by me, and then we know there is Yak Tiger 88 right there. Okay, that's fine. We are going behind the ridge, so we are safe from his fire, fire range, and hopefully we'll get a bit more spots from this V-push. I was hoping that I am going to get spotting on this Yak Tiger, but, let's be honest. When you look at the maxi map and you see our view range, even with the binos right now, it's highly unlikely that we'll be able to spot him. However, WZ114 sitting there, it's Rheinmetall Borsig. Okay, so he peaked, 50-120 peaked. I'm close, but obviously, having a camonet and pretty good crew on this TD always is quite safe to sit in a bush like that. 53-55 artillery have finished WZ-1114, which is good news. What I'm thinking right now is, okay, this AMX-50-120 is on 570 health. Being quite real with the RNG in this battle, I'm definitely not going for him, okay? It's not a one-shot for me. If I had a high roll, yes, but it's highly unlikely. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to chill a wee bit more. I know he's not showing up right now, so I'm thinking I'm maybe dropping into another ditch there. And maybe even proxy spot him and maybe have a wee sneak peek at the very corner of the map, JK78 or 67, so to speak. What can we do right now is, right, I see our T-44-100 and Conway, they're simply just chilling at the back. Conway is slightly moving, but T44-100 as well. But nothing really major that could help us in our persuasion of our good damage. Udes for the damage spotted and lost. It's not lost, mate. Not lost. Udes just complaining in the chat. So what are we hoping for as spots? And we hopefully, yes, Jack Tiger there, right there. So spotted him and spotted Waffenträger auf Panzer 4. And we are getting some spotting damage already, which is quite nice. Can't complain there. We are already up to 3000 damage and 1853 assisted damage. And we are hoping for some more. He's one shot right now, okay? He's 409, and even with the low roll, you know, even being quite pessimistic, I think we are quite good to think that we should be able to take him off in one shot. However, oh, Waffenträger of Panzer 4, he relocated and quite smartly and hitting us for 548, which is quite sad. Nevertheless, I have still 50 more hit points, or 51 more hit points than I need, you know, so it's there on. What we are looking for is hopefully we'll get our happy days. T-44-100 eliminated AMX-51-20 from the game, which is opening our gates to. There is Rheinmetall Borsig right there, and he's not spotting me anymore, which is grand, and there is two more artillery. So what I'm hoping for is getting some more damage, getting some more assisted damage, and let's be hopeful that we can do it. So, piri, which is quite, oh yes, Waffenträger of Panzer 4 was eliminated from the game by our artillery, which is great, and I'm hoping that the artillery is not right there behind that we push aiming at me, and no, it's not the case. So where are they? I'm thinking, oh, hello, sir. Oh, I'm preempt. Boom. So GW Tiger P eliminated M53-55 eliminated. So there we go. 3,500 damage. And believe or not, in the post-game stats, which I'll be obviously posting for you right there, you will find that there is more assisted damage, which we have done in this game. So overall, 6.55 combined damage, which is grand. So check out post-game stats and every pictures I posted on Twitter, link find below the video. If you like it, please do the usual stuff, you know, thumbs up and subscribe, possibly, hopefully, and see you next time. Thank you very much.